my sword, there he shall stay.
And so it was. An age of mystical wizards and courageous warriors. It was a wondrous time. The age of swords and sorcery.
And for Fatso, Whiskers, and Luke, three of our animal stars this afternoon.
All right, a nice flight from Arrow. Thank you. Thanks, Mark. We have another bird for you. This one's brand new to our show. It's Here We Go. Wow, good job, Sparky. Thank you. How about a volunteer over here with a $20 bill that would like to work with Sparky? We'll get this back to you. Go ahead and stand up again for me and put that hand out again. In fact, put the other one out too. Perfect. You flap real hard and come get this. Just one hand out. Turn your palm up for me if you would. Spark, take that back to her. She was a good sport. Set it right back down in her hands. Don't move. No. Hardest part is training the actress. You put your hand out. Hold still. Don't move. He'll set it in your hands. Pick that up, Spark. Take that back to her one more time. One. There she is. She won't touch you this time. There we go. Good job, Sparky. How about a hand for Spark? There you go. A few munchies here, all done, off we go. That's our stage hand. We have a special guest, Hoppy. What are you doing out here? Hey, look, I told you we'll discuss your contract over breakfast. Now go on, get out of here. What a ham. He's like bacon on a hot day like this. Those are pretty bad. Okay, we really do have a special guest star. This one you may recognize from a Coors beer commercial. You can run a tire commercial episode of Family Matters. It's Lowell. Come on out here, Lowell. Looking pretty good. How about waving hello to the folks, though? How about a big Hollywood smile for everyone? Big smile. No, that's not a smile. Show them a big smile. There you go. Big smile. How about showing them that tongue? You got a pretty funny tongue. Stick it out there. Good. Yeah, that's pretty disgusting. He's got some pretty funny lips, too. Let's show him those lips, Lowell. Big, huge orangutan lips. He can do an impersonation. Mick Jagger. Embarrassed, Lowell, you do a very good Mick Jagger. Hey, you've been out here checking out these folks. You like this group of folks? You do? You sure? Well, if you like them so much, blow them some kisses. That's very nice. Well, if you like them, then you must like me, huh? What do you mean, no? Quit fooling around. Stand up straight. Stand up. Quit fooling around. Tell the folks what you think about me. Go ahead. That's disgusting. What are you hitting me for? Hey, we're trying to do a show. Knock that off. Folks, I don't know what's gotten into Lowell. How about a hand for Lowell? Often in TV and movie work for and dogs, I'd like to bring out one of my favorites. I'm sure you'll recognize him. It's Benji. Come on out here, Benji. Good boy, Benji. Now, Benji just landed a new part in a big movie called Backdraft 2. He's got a big dramatic scene he likes to show everybody after he jumps in front of me all day long. There you go, Benji. Now, in the scene, he's supposed to crawl into a burning building. There's smoke. Hey, cheater, cheater.
What is that?
That's just a piece of carpet. Come over here. Let's try that again. Sit. Lay down. Taking two. Ready? Crawling into that burning building. Now, there's smoke and flames everywhere. It's going to fill his lungs. He's going to sniff the carpet again, and then he's going to pass out from smoke inhalation. There we go. Pretty convincing with that tail wagging. Now, the fireman's noticed that Benji's been in there way too long, so the fireman's going to rush in and save this dog who is passed out. You're a passed out dog. No, you're passed out. Like a light. Passed out. Way passed out. Really passed out. There it is. But, he's not passed out anymore. He's dead. With his eyes open. Fireman's gonna rush him outside, lay him down on the sidewalk. He'll get a breath of fresh air in his lungs. He'll jump up, run back in the building, and save the kittens that are inside. Jump up and run back in the building. Now you're passed out, huh? Hey, look, this part pays $1 million. You get to work with a French poodle. Hey, look at that. Bo and I are going to show you just a few more dog basics that every good studio dog needs to know before he gets a part in television and movie productions. Ready? Good boy. Turn that way for me. Good. Turn the other way. Good. Sit. Show him how handsome you are. Look here. Good. Sit up. Up high. And take a bow. Good job, Bo. I'll get it. There you go. Come on over here. Let's show him some more dog acting. Ready? A few more. Sit.